live forever.
Amen.
So where the confusion comes in.
My God.
Because God has not fully revealed his plan.
Yeah.
And God doesn't operate on time, the time schedule that you and I operate
Amen.
On.
Amen.
It's 8:20 for us, and ain't no telling what it is for God.
Oh,
y'all ain't saying
Lord.
That. It is October the 4th for
yeah.
us, but ain't no telling what it is for God.
Yeah.
Because God doesn't operate on the time schedule
Ooh.
That you and I operate
Lord.
On. And that's why the scripture just used the term the fullness
yeah.
of time.
Ooh.
And what that means is when God got good and ready.
Amen. 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 Amen.
So. Bible said God gave them laws, rules.
Yeah.
Yes. Paul says, I wouldn't have known sin had it not been for the law.
All right, yeah. all right, amen.
See, another way, y'all ain't saying that, but if God hadn't said, don't do this and don't do that,
yeah.
there would have been nothing wrong with it.
Yeah.
He said one time through Ezekiel, he said, I gave them laws that
yeah.
were not good for
yeah,
them.
Yeah, yeah, amen.
Now, the Bible says that we know that the law was good, it was right, and it
yeah.
was holy.
Uh-huh.
But when he tells Ezekiel, I gave them laws that were not good
yeah.
for them, that's to say God knew our nature and our desires.
Amen.
And if everything that we would desire,
yeah.
God would cause that to be forbidden.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it wasn't to deprive us,
yeah.
but it was to remind us, to ever remind
yeah.
us that we could not come up to
yeah.
God's standards on our own.
Amen.
Everything
Amen.
Said and done in the Old Testament after the fall in the garden
Amen.
Was designed to show man that he needed a Savior.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I still submit tonight that if you show me a man or a woman who you can't convince that they need a Savior, they're already doomed for hell and destruction. The Old Testament, God gave laws, and I see folk now, even now, and I really cannot understand why anybody in the United States of America that speaks English would ever try to talk about getting in heaven over the Ten Commandments.
All right, all right. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Y'all looking like y'all saw where you could.
Have mercy.
First off, I submit to you that there were far more than 10.
Yes, it was.
God's chosen people in the Old Testament were the Israelites.
Yeah.
They were the descendants of Abraham,
yeah.
who later became the descendants of Isaac,
yeah.
who then became the descendants of Jacob, whose
right.
name was changed to Israel,
yeah.
which gives us Israelites. And that's what we got to talk about tonight, because in the 10th chapter of Romans, that's who that's about. Amen.
Amen.
But God made what was called covenants
yeah.
in the Old Testament.
Yeah.
We had Abrahamic covenants,
yeah.
Adamic covenants,
yeah.
Isaiah covenants. And what that said was whoever's name I call
Amen.
Whatever
yeah.
type covenant, that was a contract
yeah.
that God made with them.
Yeah. Yeah.
You understand,
Amen.
For instance, God told them that when they have a male child on the eighth day,
yeah,
yeah, they were to circumcise him.
Yeah.
And now you got folk over here
uh-huh.
telling folk that they got to be circumcised
yeah.
in order to be saved.
Albert.
Y'all ain't saying
Albert.
You can be saved,
yeah.
but you can't save yourself.
Amen.
And throughout the Old Testament, God was trying to show man that he really needed
yeah.
a Savior. So the laws that God gave, they were utterly impossible
yeah.
for any man to keep.
Amen.
Let me say it another way then. Any man that was born of the sinful bloodline of Adam.
Amen.
Which would include every man
Amen.
Until Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
That's why Jesus had shucks. No heavenly mother and
yeah.
no earthly father.
Yeah.
that his bloodline would not be tainted. That's why his blood could do what Abraham's blood could not do. That's why his blood could do what Isaac's blood could not do. That's why his blood could do what Moses' blood could not do. You understand that? That's why he had to impregnate Mary, the virgin. And I ain't talking about these folk who have the right virgin on their forehead. I'm talking about a clear-cut virgin. Yeah. Before we change the meaning of virgin, y'all got to say nothing. Hallelujah. Yeah. She was so virgin till they called her Virgin Mary. Y'all ain't got to say that. I ain't talking about these almost possible virgins.
Yeah.
He impregnated her.
Yeah.
With the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Cause the angel to come down and declare.
Amen.
Tell her fiance, woo, Joseph, that fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife. That which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. She shall pray for a child, and he shall. From our sin. He'll say the word.
Amen.
So,
thank you.
Why would God give us laws he knew we couldn't keep?
Amen.
Right.
All right.
I can't say it worked.
Uh-huh.
But the purpose was so that we could know of a surety. We were lacking something.
Amen.
So that we could know that we were trying to do something. We needed to do something. We were mandated. We were ordered to do something, but we didn't have the power to do.
Amen. That's right.
God did that.
Yes.
So that when Jesus did come.
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Lord.
Folk really would say joy to the world.
Glory.
Folk really would be excited.
Amen.
That the Savior had come.
Yes.
You know, when you tried to do something that was important.
Yes.
Something that was required of you.
Yes.
You have no ability within yourself to do it.
Yes.
And along comes somebody.
Amen.
Who can do it like that.
Glory.
And make it look easy to you. You know Jesus came to pay the price for your sin and my sin. He came. He said, for this cause and I'm through the world. But we still can't sort them out. In the Old Testament, the first scripture I read to you tonight, and I ain't going to even look back at it, so we won't have to stay all night this time. But I'm going to paraphrase. When Moses was getting ready to die, after he had led the children of Israel out of Egypt, you know, God had delivered them with a mighty and an outstretched hand.
Amen.
And what I mean, God had delivered them in a way that they couldn't say they had delivered themselves. And God will put you in a place like that sometimes where mom and daddy can't get the credit. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Where your best friend can't do nothing for you. God will put you in a place where you don't have to send nobody but God who brought me. You've been to a place where you had to send. Had it not been for the Lord who was on my side, you've been in a position before. Had God not intervened, you died a long